What is good, friends? Back with more World Cup, and we got a loan from Team Italy versus Nintendo. From Team Brazil, we're gonna rewatch the first few turns. I'm not really sure why he went for rocks and let it get poisoned, because it's obviously a defog scummery, like double defog this team is based around, that you don't get up hazards. But interesting that he has a slow, but it could be Mega. Usually don't see that on the team. He turns out into Magnezone and defog. This is obviously Shedshell, so he's gonna switch out here. Don't doubles into Celebi. Not really sure what he predicted. Oh yeah, he predicted the duck to you. Yeah, he predicted the duck to you. Nice play. Gets up a Calm Mind here to +2. Has a chance he's gonna go for Toxic or Rocks? Rocks, okay. And he goes for Baton Pass. Baton Pass is still allowed in RS, it's interesting. Baton Pass into Keldeo, but he gets poisoned. But if this Keldeo has Rest, it's gonna be... it actually doesn't break the... It doesn't break the Clefable. The Clefable is unaware. But yeah, this could be Specs Keldeo, maybe? Yeah, I think I have a team like this. Because that scalded a lot to Unaware Clef. And he just goes hard for Moonlight, he doesn't want to play around. Burn's still doing 12% in Aura, so there's more than Leftovers can heal. And yeah, there's obviously no Zimus or anything in Aura, so otherwise maybe the Keldeo could have gone for Hydro Vortex and blew the Clef away. But I mean, it was Specs already, so it was already a boosted Scald and still didn't do enough. But he gets up his rocks again to make the Skarmory defog to get rid of the rocks on his side, but I think I'm pretty sure Nintendo will win this. Because a guy who knows how to use the stall team, and this matchup is not too bad for Nintendo either, he's definitely gonna win with it. And like, Lone is always forced to double out on the Duggy here. Because I'm pretty sure the Duggy is Sash. I mean, Nintendo can just go no chance, he doesn't have to risk anything, yeah. Yeah, I think it just go into a Chansey from Nintendo. And he keeps making the Ducktree play, and Lone keeps making the Celebi play. But it didn't really work. Like, I don't really see how he can win. Maybe a Sharpened Diancie could have put in work, but even then it also gets trapped by Duggy if the Duggy has a Sash intact. I mean, Duggy beats the Diancie, right? Yeah, it does. So yeah, never mind. He just goes for Baton Pass to get momentum. Assume it's gonna be banned Rewile. He might go for Pursuit here, but this is... Like, Lone has to predict perfect this game to have a chance. If Nintendo goes for Softball here and he goes for Pursuit, he's all... This... That's a really bad spot for Lone. The thing is, yeah, this is actually... The thing is that it's tough for Nintendo is if he goes in Skarmory and lets it get knocked off... The Magnezone can trap the Skarmory. So Nintendo might have to start predicting the Magnezone and double into Duggy in the right turn. But I assume he might also just go into Mega Slowbro, because Mega Slowbro doesn't have an item that can get knocked off, so Weavile's knockoff shouldn't do too much. Like, let's say Slowbro defensive. Let's say no item. How much does knockoff do from Choice Band Rewire? Does 50 to do 62. And how much does it do after Mega Evolution? I mean, that's a Fist Def Mega Slowbro. Yeah, most Mega Slowbros run a bit more Speed Def, so there's probably no point in running that Kelp. So before Slowbro Mega Evolves, I'm pretty sure it can switch in. But after Slowbro Mega Evolves, I'm pretty sure it can switch in on Rewire. So yeah, this is a tough turn for Nintendo because... Yeah, I think the Weavile just gonna click knockoff. At first I thought Pursuit might be the play, but knockoff is fine because if the Skarmory comes out, it's gonna make for a lot of mind games, because then it loses the Shed Shell and yeah, the threat of Magnezone is there. So that is the only thing that keeps this game interesting, that he has something that can potentially get rid of the Shed Shell and Skarm. But overall I think it's still a little in Nintendo's favor. So he goes into Zapdos, that does a ton. The next knockoff might not kill the Zapdos because he lost his item. Say OE defensive, yeah, it does 55. It did 59, so the Zapdos is a bit more offensive than this. So maybe let's put this spread. Let's say no item on Zapdos, and how much does it do then? It still is a roll. He needs, yeah, he probably can't kill, he needs absolute max. Because we know this was at 41, but It was 41, but it's showdown, so he was at 40, because showdown rounds, weird. So if this has sharpened, can maybe beat this. Oh, he gets a crit, and that does absolutely nothing. Holy, that did 5. So I assume this this is like non-max attack, the anti more special attack orientated, because it did absolutely nothing. But even if he was able to break through the Chansey with that crit, he would have gotten revenged by the Dougie. But yeah, Chansey is a big part of Nintendo's team, so that would have still been really annoying for him to lose that. But yeah, I guess Nintendo played that fine. Like, he went Zapdos, knowing the Zapdos would come out and he could more than likely live too. I assume he ran the Kalk. Like, it was in his favor to live too, for sure, yeah. The thing is, he has to predict another turn here. If he predicts Icicle Crush, he goes into Slowbro. Yeah, the thing is that P2 said it in the chat earlier. Lone's Hazard Setter is a weight, is always dead already. And he's not gonna be able to apply passive pressure, which you need to beat this kind of team, exactly. That's what I'm saying. Like, he has to predict perfectly with his Weaver between going for knockoff, catching the Skarmory. But if he goes for Icicle Crash here, that lets some other monster in. I'm thinking that Nintendo might go into Clef, but he goes into Slowbro. Yeah, that's a fine play by Nintendo. That's a fine play for Nintendo, because he sees that this locks himself into knockoff. Now he gets a free switch into Zapdos and he gets his regenerator back. I can also see Nintendo making an aggressive play, stay in here. He doesn't have to, but I can see him making that play. He doesn't lose anything from Zapdos, and Lone is going to be forced to double, which is why Nintendo might stay in, but he's obviously just going to make the safe play. Like, I guess he doesn't have to risk anything, but I would have considered making that play. It might not be necessary. It's probably the wrong play. Like, I just like aggressive stall players. Like, PC, how he played the stall yesterday, I kind of liked that, the way he played that. Staying in with the Sableye all the time, the Clef never went for Moonblast when he stayed, and it was so funny. If he beats all 6 of Nintendo's Pokemon, he wins. P2 is so smart. Oh my god, yeah, the Smokto shit is trolling, I'm not gonna read that out. So he gets in the Wii Ball again with a Baton Pass. I love how this thing is called Moray and went for Baton Pass, and the guy in our chat that is called Moray. I think he's UK, like, he lives in UK, but he doesn't play World Cup. I don't know how good he is. But we always are in call and the guy doesn't have a mic, so we troll him. So that was kind of funny to me. Nice play, but that did 5. What the fuck was that? Is that bandit damage? You sure that was bandit? Because that bounced off the Chansey. What the fuck? Yeah, he probably knew that he was going Zapdos or Slowbro, so he pursued the Chansey. And then he making a nice aggressive play, like, he didn't lose anything from making that play. Like, he didn't lose anything, so it wasn't even an aggressive play, but it was just a smart play from Nintendo. Because if he pursues there, yeah, you pursued the Zapdos, but it's still okay, and he gets to heal his Chansey anyway. And yeah, if he, like, goes into something else, Chansey heals on everything besides Kelio. Like, the only way, the only one that you probably won't heal on is the Landorus, because you want to go hard into your defoggers on the Landorus so that he never gets up rocks, because you just want to make sure that he doesn't get up rocks, and then you're good to go with the with this fat team. League. Look at League. I'm not gonna say anything, but he keeps pursuing, but I don't think this helps him. If he Icicle crashed there, he would have gotten rid of the Zapdos. That was the second time he went Zapdos. Zapdos probably can live one Icicle crash. It does 89 to 106, so yeah, it probably doesn't live. So if he just Icicle crashed one of those turns he pursued it, he would have gotten rid of one of the defoggers. Yeah, this game is over. I mean, he got in his Landorus here, but I mean, I'm sure Lone could have played a bit different, but I don't think he can win this at all. Like, I mean, he gets his rocks up, but this is gonna defog. It's gonna U-turn out, so he doesn't die to poison. But I agree with Intendi going hard into his defog mon. If he has knockoff on this, that would help to get rid of the Shed Shell, but he doesn't have knockoff. He would have gone for it early, I assume. Yeah, I agree with Intendi not healing the chance there, because if Fox go up, then he would have U-turned and he wouldn't have allowed you to defog, and then he can double around. Like, I would rather have some chip damage on Chansey than... Okay, I was just checking if the video that I just uploaded went public, because I didn't make a thumbnail yet. I mention that sometimes. I don't want videos going up without a thumbnail. I mean, I do it like... I did it like a few times when I didn't have the thumbnail ready and I was busy recording something else, so I didn't want to wait too long, but most of the times I'll just make a thumbnail first before I upload. But yeah, like I said, he just defogs the rocks away and he's gonna go back into Chansey or Ductrio here, thanks to Shed Shell allowing him to switch out. Why did he say rocks are here to stay for a bit? What? Yeah, I'm confused by this Mokdush chat. Did I overlook something? I don't know. Sometimes the set chat confuses me. Like, sometimes I overlook something and the chat can help you, but other times it can confuse you. So yeah, I'm not gonna... I shouldn't rely on Mokdush chat giving me that info. Forgot Lando is faster than Scar. Okay, no. I mean, Kelio, I don't think this can kill the Zapdos. Assuming. Did he just run HP Eyes or Heat Wave and Auras? Yeah, I thought he would just go for Discharge, but then I was thinking if he had Heat Wave, I would have gone for that, because this was so the obvious Celebi, like the most obvious Celebi ever. Yeah, I assume he's gonna keep Baton Passing, because he don't want to let the Chansey heal to full. I think Team Italy is 5-2 at the moment, so in Brazil I think it's 3-4. Wait, why did I switch sides? What the fuck? So yeah, but Tom has the Magna Zone, but then again doesn't do anything. Like, this is just repetitive, like chat. But it, like, he can double around, but it's not like Nintendo is threatened, because he can always switch out. The only way he could have gotten a kill yet is if he crashed earlier with the Weavile when the Zapdos came in. So he finally goes hard into he goes for Flash Can this time instead of doubling out the zone, and now he's trapped by Dougie. So yeah, he wastes his Focus Sash, but he doesn't really need his Focus Sash. I mean, DNC can get annoying if he lets his Chansey get too low, but he's not gonna let that happen. But yeah, if DNC can get the crit here and there, it can win this now. Maybe. So I assume he's gonna pursue the Dougie, but if he pursues the Dougie, the chance he goes back to 100%, gets a free softball. So I guess he can just... He might just go for a knockoff or crash. He goes for pursuit, yep, okay. I mean, it works, but now the chance he gets the free heal, so like Nintendo literally didn't lose anything from switching there. Actually, did he? What did he even switch out into? So now he gets to heal his Clefable, which is something else. I mean, he gets to go for Heal Bell here. And this is really helpful for Nintendo in the sense that... Like, he can click Wish or Heal Bell here. It's helpful for Nintendo in the sense that... If this Kaldio ever gets a Calm Mind passed again with the Celebi, he's gonna be able to have this healthy and check the kill better. So yeah. Pretty much this game is over as long as Nintendo doesn't make a mistake. Yeah, I think it was worth it, Padlop. I mean, he didn't have to make that play, but like, it worked out for Nintendo. Like, see, he went for Healable, now he's getting his for Fable, slowly healthier. And you can go for Wish here, because I don't think this... Yeah, if this DNC crits here, is actually going to be a threat. But I don't think it's going to be able to kill this. Yeah, this, I'm just happy that this game doesn't take like 5 hours. Like, you know, some install games take really long. We already have 50 minutes in. 2 months died, so. Whew. It's funny that the boat, that the two Trapamons, the one mon trap, the one Trapamon trapped the other Trapamon, and then he got pursued. So basically, by another trapping move. And then he probably went in Galaxy, but he doesn't have good switchings. Chansey can't switch in at 60, I assume, and... Actually, Chansey can switch in on Moonblast, but... What if he Diamond Storms here, so that's too risky for Nintendo. Diamond Storm crit didn't even do half to Chansey, but two Diamond Storms should still do 60, so yeah, I don't think that's the play switching with Chansey. He's either gonna sack something that he doesn't need. Does he need the Zapdos in this game? I think he can potentially sack the Zapdos, but yeah, otherwise he's just gonna go for Wish here, because this should be able to live any hit. As you see, that does absolutely nothing, because this is like more special attack orientated. A crit, I don't think a crit would have even killed this. But yeah, now he gets this Clefable even more healthy, and yeah, you guys can see this game is over. Like, Lone pretty much doesn't have anything to break this team. A well-played Weavile could have put in some more work, but I'm not gonna say that he misplayed anything. It was like, if I saw the stall team, I would've been so mad and like... Like, it's hard for me to say because I don't know all his sets. Actually, I know most of his sets. To be honest, if Nintendo plays this perfect, I think he won this no matter what Lone did. Yeah, that's just how I see it. I mean, Moonblast actually does a lot, so Moonblast has 55, so this is more fist dev, this is more special attack, so I don't know why he ever went for Diamond Storm, unless he predicted the Chansey switch. But I mean, when he went, Moonblast at 58, I think the Chansey was at 57, the Clef was at 57 when he went for Wish, so if he went for Moonblast on that turn and got the roll, maybe he had a slight chance. But yeah, I don't know why Diamond Storm was ever the play, because it was pretty... I think pretty obvious from the earlier damage to the skull damage to this that it is more fist dev orientated, and from the Diamond Stone crit that didn't even do half to Chansey, it was pretty obvious that this is more special attack based, right? I'm not really sure, maybe, like I said, unless he predicted the Chansey. Like, see, he's getting the 50 air rolls. If he got that on the turn where he was at 57, he would have been dead, yeah. That's off power, so he's fishing for speed death drops. I just didn't want to waste the Moonblast PP on the obvious knock, on the obvious protect. Now gets a low roll. And then you can switch out into this Chansey here. But he just goes for protect. Okay, that's fine too. I mean, what is this even gonna do to Celebi? This just gives him a free switch into Chansey, but he didn't take it. Goes for Wish first. I think he's gonna go Chansey now. Maybe he's even gonna Moonblast, but yeah, he just goes Chansey. And not sure what he's gonna go to, because like I said, like, Diancie can't break the Chansey. Keltia just brings back in... Oh, he goes to Weavile with a Callman boost, so he just used the Baton Blast for momentum, not for the boost. So, do you go for... Nintendo's not staying in here. Do you go for... You break the Zapdos, you go for Crash again. I mean, I can understand why Nintendo went into Zapdos early on the Wii, because Zapdos is nice for Nintendo, but it's not necessary for him to win the game. Because between these four Pokemons, he pretty much waltz everything, I think. Especially if he gets the Mega off on his Slowbro eventually. But he goes, yeah, he can even go into Skarmory, obviously. Because the only reason he didn't go into Skarmory earlier was that the Magnezone was in the back, and if he got knocked off, it would have been bad for him. But yeah, now Nintendo with a Sixth Sense there switches out on the crit, so he would have lost his Skarmory if he stayed in there. And now he gets a free Slag off. He can even Mega Evolve, so this is a switching into knockoff from Mewell now. Which, yeah, I agree with that play, because his Skarmory was kind of low, so he didn't really have a switch into Mewell at that point. So Megaing this makes sure he can switch into Weavile, because I can show you guys the calc. Like, let's say Mega Slowbro, right? This is an uber set that's running max defense, but let's say he only has 132 defense. Knockoff does 80, that's 38 to 45 from Bandit Weavile, which is like absolutely nothing. You also can't get crit because you have shell armor. So he goes for the Calm Mind thing and the Baton Bath again into Keldeo, but he's gonna take poison damage. This is a free switch into Celebi, into Clefable, what am I saying? They both start with C, so I mixed them up. Gilas might play tomorrow. Yeah, I hope there's like a break between games in a bit, because I really gotta eat. And chill out a bit. He goes Slowbro, which also is a fine play, but I think... Yeah, Slowbro is fine too. So especially if you run some Spadef, yeah, you can see like there was a plus one Skull and did absolutely nothing. So he's probably mixed defensive Slowbro like as I expected, and this game has been over forever, but I can understand that Lone is still trying for his team. If he gets some crits, maybe he has a slight chance, but I don't think so. Suits the Chansey, which is nice, but... He's gonna go Celebi or... Yeah, he's gonna go Keldeo, wow. So he doubled out into Chansey, which is a safe play from Nintendo, and would have worked out the Weavile stayed and went for Pursuit, or if the Celebi came out, he would have been able to heal up. But yeah, he goes in the Clef, obviously not risking a Secret Sword. I think the Keldeo already showed that it's Specs from earlier. Like, I'm not 100% sure because I didn't calc it, but I think it was Specs because it did a good amount to unaware Clef. Yeah, he gets a free wish. And he gets to... Actually, he doesn't... I don't think he gets to go Chansey here, because the wish from Clef doesn't heal that much. I think Mega Slowbro should be able to switch into this. Actually, Moonblast might do too much. Yeah, I can see Nintendo just going for Moonblast here. Yeah, exactly. Because it was kind of risky to switch into this. Nah, actually, Skarmory switches into this, because it doesn't have HP Fire. Yeah, Skarmory could have switched into this. I mean, obviously Nintendo wins, I don't know what arguing or asking the chat. Yeah, I thought was fishing for a Spadef drop. Nintendo's gonna wish up again. And yeah, he only has 12 Moonbats left. You can also go Skarmory, yeah, Skarmory waltz this. Call him a Flex Masters V60. I mean, they're acting like there was a gold play. If it was ghosting, this would have been over 10-1. Nintendo's in the driver's seat, but there's still a possibility of him screwing up. I mean, Nintendo's not messing up, it's Nintendo, like... This guy's like 14 or something, he's like young. He's a genius. Yeah, he knows that the Yancey can't touched its Skarmory, like it only has Diamond Storm and Moonblast. Like, see, Diamond Storm, like, does nothing. But the thing is, the Skarmory can't do anything back to the end. He has Toxic Defog Roost. And what was the last move again? It's either Brave Bird for Heracross, or what else would it be? Brave Bird or Whirlwind, or... Spikes. No, I don't think it's Spikes on this team. It's double defog, basically. You won't have Spikes on that team. You're not sure what the last move is. I think Brave Bird or Whirlwind. So that a scum can touch the DNC, but the DNC can touch the scum. So yeah, fun times. Fun times. But yeah, if he wastes Moonblast PP, if he's out of them, then he can just go into Clef and Walders. And yeah, the only reason why he's not going Chansey is because he's too low, obviously. And he's not risking anything. He's playing it safe. He should have to win if he plays it safe. I get an Atten Force to four, but it's hard to watch. I mean, the only reason why it's hard to watch for me is because I'm really hungry at the moment. But I mean, I got used to watching Stall. Like, I'm fine with watching this. I know that some people won't watch this entire thing, but that's fine. Oh yeah, counter is obviously the last move. I don't know how I could forget about that. It was between counter, Whirlwind, and Brave Bird, but I don't know why I only said Brave Bird and Whirlwind. I mean, Brave Bird is a bit more reliable, I feel, versus Heracross. But if it's he gets its backs toxic on this little one and misses, that is a bit annoying. I mean, I don't think it was like game changing, but like Lone can't afford to like miss that toxic because he's already in a bad spot. I mean, it would have been hard for Lone to make a correct double that pressures the stops the Clef from heal belling up anyway, so I don't think that toxic miss was really game changing, but it obviously was sucked. Yeah, it didn't change much. I mean, yeah, he had to heal ball, but he gets off the heal ball pretty free. Yeah, not game changing. Just, I mean, obviously I would be really annoyed here if I was alone, because you got the toxic play correct on the slow and you miss, and like you have nothing going away already. The matchup is annoying for him. Yeah, little Chansey, yeah, that's exactly true, because Chansey has so much PP. Clefable's Wish doesn't do much. So now he got up rocks on top of that, which means that the Landorus T is dead. Lone can't get up rocks, Lone doesn't have hazard control. So the only way of preventing hazards was going DNC there. So yeah, this is, and going DNC wouldn't do anything because Chansey just beats it with softballs and seismic toss. So this game is officially over now. He got his nice Calm Mind boosts. But he's just gonna go into Clefable or softballed first. Like, he could have just softballed and then go into Clefable. Yeah, exactly. Seismic Toss was also in case he passed that into Kelly, so Kelly would just die. And yeah, exactly. Yeah, he didn't have anything basically to Baton Pass into. And Celebi itself doesn't beat Chansey. And like, yeah, okay, he passed this into DNC. But this Moonblast is gonna bounce off. This Moonblast is gonna bounce up, dude. I don't wanna say anything in chat, I feel like I might get muted. I mean, it's not ghosting if I say Moonblast is gonna bounce up, right? But you never know. They have been kinda strict with like warning or like muting people. Not that I really care if I get muted, cause I don't talk much in the chat anyway. Oh my god, never mind. Okay, now I'm glad that I didn't say in the chat. That actually did a good chunk. The thing is, he only has 9. Softball has 12 PP. So Nintendo just spams softball here, and if the only way for Lone to put in work here is get his Bedef drop. Nintendo can either softball spam here, or he can go out into his Skarmory. He has 2 options. Which is the better play, let me think. Actually, he can't go into Skarmory, what am I saying? He can't go into Skarmory. I thought Skarmory is obviously gonna get blown away by this, because it's plus 4. So yeah, he's forced to softball. So softball spam is which is the first option that I told you guys. So yeah, I made some little errors there. But yeah, overall, if he doesn't get the Spadef drop, yeah, he can even go for Seismic Toss there because he was healthy enough to live Moonblast. Moonblast was doing 54, right? 56. So if it's a death drop. Oh, he gets a crit! There we go, the game is coming closer now. But the thing is, he just goes into Clefable here and he's unaware. I mean, he gets the crit, but like, losing Chansey, what does that open up? That opens up the Celebi a bit, but Celebi still gets annoyed by Skarmory and by Zap. Yeah, Celebi gets walled by Zapdos. Yeah, but if he teams up enough, it only gets walled by Clef. So yeah, maybe we have a game here now that he got that crit. This might be close. I had to mess up my duration a little bit during the end there. Man, I just thought Yancy would eat that up. It's just plus 4, it's not plus 6. Yeah, I said Yancy was... I assume it's Yancy's like almost max special attack, but I'll just calc with max special attack for now. So he sends it to Clef. Okay, how much is Moonblast? That's way more important. How much does Moonblast do from Clef? It's 37 to 44. So he's he's protecting to like stall out Moonblast or Earthpaw BP. The thing is, if he gets this Bedevil drop, he has to wish here, right? If he gets this Bedevil drop, this DNC can win, yeah. Yeah, but it's still looking good for Nintendi. He can go for Moonblast here, and Moonblast basically 2-hit KOs the DNC. Okay, that's a DPP game going on. Yeah, I saw Aim played earlier for DPP, but I didn't record it on purpose, because, like, if I don't have people in call that support me, I'm not going to narrate DPP most of the time. But yeah, Tama homie is playing. I think he's losing. Yeah, he lost. But I don't know which team these guys are on. So, that does 58. That's a special attack drop. But this Moonblast is a 2-hit KO no matter what, so the special attack drop doesn't matter too much. He's obviously gonna go for Protecty to get more leftovers. And how many Moonblasts do you have left, my friend? 6. So he's forced to wish. Actually, does he need health on this Clefable, or can he afford the Moonblast here? Let me think. Yeah, he needs this for Calmant Celebi, I think, yeah. Because Calmant Celebi can win otherwise. At plus 6, yep. But it's actually a really cool strategy, like Comet pass into Specs Keld or into DNC. If I miscalc in the Keldeo's Scarf, you guys can let me know in the comments, and I'm a young fool, but I think the Keldeo was Specs. Meanwhile, Aura still has 1000 turns left. I mean, that's not really true. I think this is gonna be over in like the next 8 to 10 minutes. That was quick as fuck. Yeah, I didn't even realize there was a DPP game. When did it even start? Let me scroll up. I'm not sure. So he goes into Zapdos. So he's willing to sack his Zapdos. Then he's gonna go back into Clefable so he gets another Protect off. But yo, this is gonna be close now. If he crits the Clefable, this DNC wins. This Gummy can't touch it. He's gonna obviously go Protect. That's the only reason why Nintendo sacked the Zapdos. So he gets a guaranteed Protect off and more health. And he does 57, gets another special attack draw, and Moonblast kills the DNC. And yeah, whatever he brings out. If he brings out the Weavile, I assume he's just gonna protect on the Icicle Crash. Then Lone is forced to double, Lone has rocks on his side. Yeah, like DDNC was like basically his chance to bring it back. I actually thought Nintendo would have won it super easy, but the Calmant pass on DDNC plus the crit on the Chansey made it kinda close. So League is saying Lone could have had this, he needed to make the switch to Keldeo after he pursued the Chansey every time. That prevents the heal. I mean, I think eventually he would have gotten the heal off, like you can predict it sometimes. But wasn't this Keldeo poisoned? Like, if the Keldeo, correct me if I'm wrong, but if the Keldeo was poisoned, and if you keep doubling it in, it's eventually, like, not gonna work out for you. Right? Because you're gonna go down eventually to poison. But yeah, his way of winning now is basically not really existent because you can't even crit the Mega Slowbro with the Weavile. So if you go for Weavile and Icicle Crush, like I said, you're forced to double and you take rocks every time. Landis is already dead to rocks, so it's basically 3 versus 3 at this point. He said test. I mean, your opponent is thinking, obviously. Also should have just checked it after every wish on Clef. Did he mean protect with a DNC or protect with a Chansey? Like, which player are you talking about? I think he's talking about the DNC, but I'm not sure. But yeah, he goes Weavile, he's gonna protect the scout what it's locked itself into. Talked about this a few times already now. Yeah, I don't think he was winning this. He actually brought it closer than I thought. Like, I thought Nintendo was just 5-0. After the scenario where Dougie and Zone both went down after the Weavile tripped the Dougie, I think that Nintendo just had it. But yeah, he's gonna bring in his Mega Slowbro here. Don't can double into Celebi, but it doesn't really matter, right? Does it? Yeah, like, I'm pretty sure he has to double. Maybe the CM Celebi can still win this. If this runs out of wishes. Yeah, he only has 5 wishes left. Maybe CM Celebi can win. Combat Baton Pass, Giga Drain. I assume Recover or Psychic. Not sure the last move. But yeah, he makes a obvious double into Celebi on the Slowbro. I mean, he can predict the Clefable to come out and go for Giga Drain here. Did he do it? Nice! Good play. Because now it is a Clefable is in range to die from another one. Because I think Nintendo predicted him to Calm Mind there. Did he Calm Mind predict him to protect? He didn't. I mean, understandable. Understandable in case Nintendo doesn't predict protect. But yet, a protect from the Clef still brings it out of range, so never mind. I thought he could 2-hit KO this. He needs a crit or 2-hit KO. Because he had leftovers. Leftovers and then leftovers after the protect. The double leftovers round just brought this Clef back up. Man, I thought he was in range. I mean, not that I want Nintendo to lose. I'm fine with him winning. But, like, you know, I don't have anything against the stall team losing. Like, if a stall team loses, that's fine with me. But I'm kind of rooting. Like, in general, I would root for Nintendo. If he had, like, a neutral team that wasn't stall, I would root for him even more. But I'm still fine with him winning with stall. It's just not as fun to watch, right? Like, not many people will watch the entire video. But yeah, he didn't get the crit, and now this is back at a decent amount of health after the protect. The thing is, it's running out of wishes, and he plays it well here, goes for the Calm Mind. Because, like, if this runs out of wishes, which is it only had 4 wishes left and only 1 protect. So this is actually not over yet, I think. Yeah, exactly, he has so few wishes, this can win. If he Calm Minds again, the thing is, if his only attacking move is Giga Drain, he only has 12 HP left. Yeah, I think he still loses to PV. Like, the Skarmory 4 times resists Giga Drain. So, like, Celebi, if he doesn't have special attack investment, Giga Drain has 22 to 26. I think that's what it has been doing. And yeah, versus Skarmory at plus 6, how much would it do to Fist Staff Skarm? It would do 31 to 37, yeah, so he doesn't have enough PP. Yeah, he gets, if his only attacking move is Giga Drain, he gets PP stalled, and yeah, it seems that's his only attacking move, so yeah, this game is over. If he had a second attacking move, like Psychic, and he commented up to plus 6, he could have won this. Because Clefable, like, was running out of wishes. Yeah, and then he wins. But actually, thought he had a shot for a second. If he just had a second attacking move on Celebi, I mean, it's kind of obvious that his last move is probably going to be recover on a Celebi. He got Hydro Pumps, makes a nice play predicting. I don't know if he even predicted. I mean, he just hits this Garm the hardest and it hits the Clef hard. Like, it's just overall the hardest hitting move versus the entire team, unless he had HP Electric, which would hit Slowbro harder, but. His last move is obviously going to be Secret Sword. He already showed Skull, Toxic, and Hydro Pump. Yeah, so it's going to be Fighting Stab in the last slot. I don't know why they're saying, huh, what? Yeah, exactly. Like, Nintendo has this game. And he protects here, then he goes Slowbro. I mean, I think he should have just gone Slowbro over going Clef, but. It's still fine. Like. Kelly dies to rock, so there's no point in switching, and yeah, the protect makes it die to poison now. Landorus also dies to rocks. Does Weavile kill us with pursuit if the Clefable switches? I mean, it doesn't matter at this point, because the combination of Slowbro plus Skarmory just wins. I think the combination of Skarmory plus Slowbro should win. Maybe not. But yeah, he's gonna go into Skarmory here. They're just saying you should have gone Slowbro instead. I mean, I think it was fine. Maybe it was a better play. It shouldn't matter for the outcome of the game. He's gonna switch into Mega Slowbro here, obviously. Weavile. And his Ice Crush going for the flinch on his Skarm, staying in. And if he has. Okay, he sacks off his Landro. He just goes for Slag off. Did he predict the Landro sack? That was a calculated play. If he's Calm and Psyshock, he can maybe even beat the Celebi one on one. Because Celebi was a Slowbro. Let's say the Slowbro has. Yeah, if the Slowbro has Fist Staff, the Celebi beats it, but if the Slowbro has some Spadav, let's say like 120, given this 50 max, so Slowbro would win a Command War, but like, yeah, he wasn't gonna risk that. So he just goes, the Rocks is basically what helps Nintendo even more in this matchup. And having no Rocks on his side obviously is huge. He's gonna go back into Mega Slowbro here, he gets a Crit Pursuit, which is something, but I don't think it's gonna matter. 10 flinches. Dude, he might even need more than 10 flinches. Let's see, Weavile versus Mega Slowbro. Choice Band. It does 11 to 13%. Yeah, so he needs like 9 flinches. Oh, that's Fist Staff Slowbro, it does a bit more. But yeah, he still needs like 8 or 9, 8 flinches at least. Yeah, once he Baton Pass Command into Weavile, but I don't think that matters. Pursuit again would have been nice there, yeah. But yeah, he roots the next turn, so that doesn't really matter, yeah. Yeah, exactly, it doesn't matter at this point. Paddler preaching in the chat. Whew. Yeah, so he has to get all them flinches. I think his Weavile has one last Stealthwalk switch, and yeah, it comes in at 1%. I mean, maybe Pursuit again was the play, but I don't think he can win this anyway. Yeah, Toxic wraps this game up for Nintendo. Because he can't really Baton Pass. Because, yeah, like, Weavile's at 1%, and it's not gonna. Like, he's not gonna gain anything from a Calm Mind Baton Pass boost. Like, like a. If it gets Calm Mind's Pass, we had that happen earlier, it doesn't do anything. He's just clicking counter because it's like, so he doesn't waste Roost or either PP. And you obviously don't want to defog when there's rocks on the opposing side. They bring the Weavile to 1%. Not that the Weavile is a huge threat. Because it literally needs like 13 flinches to have a chance of winning. Like, he has to flinch the Slowbro and the Skarmory. But yeah. Can we wrap this game up already? This game is over. Yeah, clicking Toxic is smart in case he goes Weavile, or it would die. You don't really need the Toxic BP. But yeah, I can actually pull out the spreadsheet with the score and everything like that. It was hard Weavile, so if he just clicks Toxic, he is Weavile's dead. He might click Giga, Roost, yeah, he clicks Roost. So he wasn't risking, like, he gave her an extra Ultra Crit, I don't really know. It didn't matter, I would've probably clicked Toxic, because less Giga in the 20, so it's not like he went Rain Shift to Giga and crit you. But yeah, now he goes to Mega Slowbro, I assume. Because keeping Skarmory healthy is, guaranteed win versus the Celebi. Sex of the Clefable, which is completely fine. Even though I would have gone hard Slowbro. Like, he has to flinch you like so often. Like, he's gonna miss Icicle Crash before he doesn't even have enough PP to beat you now. And he goes for Calm Mind, and this Slowbro just wins the game. So I guess Mega Slowbro cleaning the end game makes me maybe put Slowbro in the thumbnail. Should I put Slowbro in the thumbnail? Comment Weavile was the counter, not really. Duck Choice Band Weavile crunched as 40-40-52. Where's my specs Weavile at? Yeah, okay, stop memeing, chat. Yeah, he can't even crit this, so yeah. He goes for Slag of just playing the extra ultra save to be at full. Why is he asking if AIM Tamahome is today? AIM just played one game. Why would he play another one? I mean, some people play two games one day, but I don't think he would play another one today. So he can comment again. So if he has Psyshock and Scald, which is, I assume, his moveset. Like, he needs to go to plus 6. Okay, never mind. He just attacked. That actually, that didn't do enough, see? Like, if he comments to plus 6 with the Slowbro, which is what he should do. Okay, never mind, it's over. I thought the Celebi would recover, but maybe he doesn't have it. I mean, it doesn't matter at this point. The Celebi was in the back with, like, the Celebi had to comment up so many times. Like, Slowbro had more comments up, so it lost to it 1v1, and yeah, even if the Celebi caught up in comments, he could still switch to Skarmory, and that wasn't happening anyway. But thank you guys for watching. Nintendo wins for Brazil. Was loaned from Team Italy. It seems they said that in the chat, he's on Italy, right? Thank you guys for watching. Anything else? And yeah, I wanted to give you guys the score from both teams. So Italy's score should be 5-3 after this game. It says 5-2 here. And oh, Germany's 5-3. I thought they were 4-3. And what is Nintendo from Brazil? Brazil should be 4-4 now. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. Dogwitch. Signing out. Bye.